Thank you. Thank you. A lot of people ask me about these old guitars and these weird old wooden cases. These guitars are both actual Civil War era instruments. The guitar that I'm playing is an 1851 Martin. It is a size 1, model 21. It's called a model 21 because it costs $21 new. Lisa is playing the cheaper of the two. She is playing an 1860 size 2, model 20. It was a dollar cheaper. So they are both actual Civil War era instruments. Lisa will tell you that I bought them new, but that's not really true.
And he'll tell me he paid $21 for them, too.
This next tune was an interesting tune. It was kind of a stolen melody. But the story of this starts in 1797. A young lady by the name of Isabella Baumfeld is born in New York State. Isabella is born a slave. New York did not abolish slavery until July 4th, 1827. So she is born one of 13 children to a Dutch farmer in upstate New York. She speaks Dutch just about all of her life, or all of her young life anyway. By the 1820s, she has been bought and sold 5 times. She has had 5 children. Only 4 of them lived. The last was a little boy born in 1820. In 1825, the little boy was taken away from her and sold illegally at a slave auction in New York State and taken to Mississippi. In 1826, Isabella escaped. Finally, on July 4, 1827, they abolished slavery. With the help of Quaker abolitionists, she filed a federal lawsuit and got her little boy back in 1828. That would be the first time she'd make national headlines. She joined the church, she stayed with the Quakers until 1843, and then she decided to become a Methodist. She went to a Methodist camp meeting. It was a very powerful religious experience for her, and after that she changed her name to Sojourner Truth. In 1851 in Akron, Ohio, at a women's convention there, she gave a speech called Ain't I a Woman, and that made national headlines for the second time. The American Civil War began, and of course she was always helping with runaway slaves and helping with civil rights in our country. When the United States Colored Troops was formed as a result of Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation, she became involved in recruiting. By this time she was living in Michigan. She helped raise the very first regiment of USCT troops in Michigan, and she wrote them a song called The Valiant Soldiers. She stole a melody that you're going to recognize immediately, but The Valiant Soldiers became one of the most important marching songs for the USCT. After the Civil War, she continued working for civil rights. She passed away in 1884 at the age of 87. She is buried in Battle Creek, Michigan. This is The Valiant Soldiers. We are the valiant soldiers who have listed for the war. We're fighting for the Union and we're fighting for the law. We'll shoot a rebel farther than the white man ever saw as we go marching on. There above the center where the flag is waving bright, we're marching out of slavery, we're bound for freedom's light. We mean to show Jeff Davis how the Africans can fight as we go marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, 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 hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah as we go marching on. We're done with hoe and corn. We're bully Yankee soldiers now as sure as you were born. When Master hears us calling, he'll think it's Gabriel's horn when we go marching on. Father Abraham has spoken and the message has been sent. The prison doors opened and out the prisoners went to join the Union Army of the African descent. As we go marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, 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 hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. As we go marching on.